Hi everyone, this is Dango. In this video, I'm going to talk about the timeline of 2019 to 2020 coronavirus outbreak in China. So I'm also going to discuss a little bit about things that could have been done so that the severity of this disaster can be reduced. So the first case was reported as a patient who visited the hospital in Wuhan on December 1st, 2019. This patient was diagnosed of being infected by one type of coronavirus on December 8, 2019. But at this point, physicians still have no idea which type of coronavirus infected this patient, because there are several different types of coronavirus. But after that, 40 more cases were reported during December, in which most of these patients were reported to travel to Hunan Seafood Wholesale Market. So this Hunan Seafood Wholesale Market has been identified as one of the hotspots for spreading this virus. And at this point, on December 30th, 2019, 8 physicians told the truth to the general public. So they basically use WeChat or Weibo to tell all their friends and family members to be careful traveling outside, because several cases has been identified as infected by coronavirus. Although they don't know which type of the coronavirus it was, but you know, on 2003 there was a horrible outbreak of the SARS, which is also one type of coronavirus. So basically, concerning about the safety of the general public, these eight physicians told the truth to the general public. But even just to try to warn people, Wuhan police just warned these eight physicians for spreading rumors, and they asked all the physicians to write something to suggest that they will never ever spread rumor again. And at the same time, Wuhan Health and Safety Center reported no new cases were found over the past 1 week. So basically, they were trying to say you don't have to worry about this disease, and they suggest that the chance for human-to-human transmission was very low. So at this point, no safety measure are asked to taken for all the citizens in Wuhan. And then on January 7th, 2020, samples collected from Hunan Safety Wholesale Market were characterized. So basically, this novel coronavirus was identified for the first time. The sequence, the DNA sequence has been characterized here. And also at the same day, US CDC, CDC, which is the basically the Center to Control the Disease, so US CDC offered help to China for the first time, and this was declined. And then on January 11th, 2020, so this is basically the start of the Spring Festival travel season. And then in Wuhan, People's Political Consultative Conference was held in Wuhan. So this is basically a very, very important important conference for the Communist Party in Wuhan province. And I guess one of the reasons that the Wuhan officials tried to hide the spread of the virus and try to say there is no safety concern is to make sure this conference to be successfully held. And and at the same day, the gene sequence of this coronavirus has been completely identified. But sadly, there are also reports that suggest multiple physicians in Wuhan are suspected to be infected. So this is very dangerous, because if that is true, that suggests the risk of human-to-human transmission was actually high, instead of low, which suggested by the Chinese officials. On 13th January 2020, one of the travelers from Wuhan to Thailand was diagnosed as a case of novel coronavirus. On January 14th, 2020, so efficient methods to diagnose this novel coronavirus was developed, but supporting Chinese government, the World Health Organization said no evidence has been found to suggest the virus can spread from human to human. So this is basically trying to support the Chinese government to calm down the Chinese people and to calm down all the people from all over the world that this virus is not dangerous because there is no spread from, there is no transmission from human to human. Yes, I think this was a big mistake because there were already reports suggesting the Chinese like the physicians in China has been infected. So this is a message that World Health Organization made that was very, very wrong. But later another case from Wuhan to Japan, another traveler was diagnosed as case of novel coronavirus. So this becomes more important because the cases were identified outside China. So if you compare this to the disaster of Chernobyl, so that was the disaster was also confirmed when people outside of Soviet Union or like figured that there could be a potential problem. In this case, yes, the coronavirus was already identified in Thailand and in Japan, and especially in Japan, they have a much better and stronger this health defense system. So after that, on January 16th, 2020, U.S. CDC starts to monitor travelers from Wuhan. To make sure they don't have high body temperature or etc. And then January 17th, 2020, scholars from UK published a report suggesting potentially there are already over 1,000 cases in China, according to a model that they used. So this model is a mathematical model, and it has a very, very huge confidential intervals. So although the report potentially case was like 1,000, but the 95 confidential intervals was from 427 to 4,471. So this is basically a huge confidential interval, which is totally acceptable because at this point you don't have like many information available. But this basically says that there are very high chance that in China already more than 400 people have been infected. And starting from this day, the infected number finally increased from the initial 41 to 62 on January 17th and to 121 on January 18th. So you can see, yeah, I have listed the case here. So at the end of December, this case number was 41, and this remained unchanged during January 1st to January 16th. This is why Wuhan official can say no cases were found over the past 1 week to the local people, because this is what they released. Like they say, there were basically no one identified as being infected during this period. But January 17th marked another stage of of this outbreak, which I call it out of control. So yeah, this is only, they only say there are like 62 identified, but to my eye, this is already a turn point of this disaster. Things starting from here goes to like very, very wrong. On January 18th, 2020, which is 1 week before the Chinese Spring Festival, which is the Chinese New Year, and Wuhan, this is a big event held on Wuhan. So Wuhan hold like a 40K family gathering event. So this is basically a huge event where more than 40K people gather together and have a big dinner. This is a huge event. And at this point, although the Chinese official already reported 121 cases, in which all of these cases were still in Wuhan or Hubei, yeah, no safety measure has been taken. We can see this is the picture taken from this event, and there is a video that you can search to figure out what happening on that day. But this is basically what happened in there, people were just celebrating, and essentially nothing safety method was taken, like no mask, no control of the body temperature. So yeah, this is just very dangerous. Later, lot of people showing up here were identified as infected of this coronavirus. So this is very sad. And keep going. On January 19th, 2020, World Health Organization suggested that the virus can spread from human to human. So this is a major, major message that World Health Organization suggests, because if this viral can transmit from human to human, then this becomes very severe and people should be starting to pay attention on that. And then on January 20th, 2020, China officials acknowledged that the novel virus can have human-to-human transmission, and the initial report of cases in Beijing, Shanghai, and other major cities in China were identified. So one of the infected case in Beijing was a guy who traveled to Wuhan for a conference, and he was a doctor in Beijing's number one, Peking University number one hospital. So yeah, so that was very sad, and that's basically a direct support of human to human transmission, because that guy never traveled to that seafood market. And then Wuhan CDC organized a special team to try to deal with this new virus. On January 22nd, 2020, China officials acknowledged that several physicians and nurses in Wuhan have been infected. So although reports have been suggested that a lot of physicians and nurses in Wuhan has been infected a long time ago, finally, China officials acknowledged that these physicians and nurses in Wuhan have been infected. The reason that these infected physicians and nurses were not reported may potentially because some officials in Wuhan tried to hold this conference successfully. Yeah, but this basically delays everything, because now this is just less than 1 week before the spring. Actually, this is 2 days before the spring festival, and most of the people out, like if they work in Wuhan but their family was from like other cities, Chinese Spring Festival is very similar to Christmas in Western countries or like Thanksgivings. So people tend to go back to their families, and at this point the reason that I call this stage out of control is because at this point still there are not enough safety measures taken to prevent the spread of the disease, and people have already traveled at this point. And here comes the hard action. So on January 23rd, 2020, China officials declared Wuhan lockdown. So basically all travels between Wuhan and other cities were temporarily suspended. So this is effect on 10 a.m. January 23rd, 2020. Many travelers and citizens in Wuhan still tried to get out before 10 a.m. Like even I remember there are reports that people were still trying to get the last train, the last airplane from Wuhan to other city, even other country. So to be honest, a lot of people were thinking about the morality of this lockdown is necessary. So from my point of view, I have some medical background a little bit. So from my point of view, this is indeed a necessary action, but this is just too late. Wuhan had a lot of better chance to stop the major spread of the disease, but Yeah, but basically, I don't know what they are doing. They did nothing at the initial stage. And the best timing to control a disaster or an outbreak of a virus is at initial stage. If you lose control at the initial stage, it already becomes very hard at this point. So, yeah, on January 23rd, 2020, China officials declared Wuhan lockdown, and following that, on January 24th, 2020, 12 cities in Hubei province were locked following the lockdown of Wuhan. So 12 cities near Wuhan also locked. But remember, at this stage, lots of the travelers from Wuhan and other city were already in other cities, in Beijing, in Shanghai, in all other cities. And on January 24th, 2020, which is one day before the Chinese New Year, so CCTV New Year Gala was still held normally. So this New Year Gala was always there. It was held every year and not missing one year. And the problem is that although in this gala, they discussed a little bit about people should wear masks when traveling outside and stop coming to Wuhan, these kind of things. But ironically, no masks were observed from the audience on site. So most Chinese people will watch this gala from their home, like watching TV. But there are still like lucky audience who can enjoy this gala on site. Sadly, none of this audience on site wear any mask. And yeah, January 25th, 2020 is Chinese New Year, but panic starts in Wuhan. The reason is because before Wuhan lockdown, people were not thinking like this disease or this virus is a serious virus or something like that. You can see even like on January 23rd, 2020, the cases reported were like 830. So this number is not that high or not very low. It's basically similar, like if you measure the radioactivity after the after the disaster, the Chernobyl disaster, you see the measured value was not very high. That's because you have a wrong instrument. The limit of the instrument is not high enough to actually catch the problem. Here is the same thing. They don't have enough reagent to actually identify all the suspected cases. This is why this number was very low. Remember the publication on January 17th, 2020. This model already suggests that there are more than 1,000 cases in China, and after that, no safety measures has been taken anywhere in China, including Wuhan. They still hold this over 40K family gathering event in Wuhan, and just imagine how this can, yeah, like. This kind of like no safety measurements can result in what kind of disaster? Yeah, there is no way at this point you have only 830 cases. This is the case that the Chinese officials or Chinese hospitals can identify maximum. It's not the real case. But before January 23rd, people in Wuhan, there is no indication that this case was that severe to the point that they have to lock down the city. So people were not prepared. This is why they were in panic. So after like at the first day or second day of the city lockdown, basically all of the foods and daily, the thing that people need daily are like all of them are gone in supermarket, and people was in great panic. So luckily later, like on January 26th, things in Wuhan starts to go back to normal. I mean, not normal, but you can at least find enough like foods and vegetables in supermarket. So that is a little bit relief. But still, yeah, it's just again, I think this lockdown was a right action to do, because at this point the outbreak is not is already out of control. So yeah, and you can see the number in Wuhan is just jumping exponentially. So there's no way to stop the spread besides city lockdown. So yeah, but it's just very, very sad to see that the Chinese officials take the action so late, so late. If they can take the action early, there's no need to lock down the city. They can just start all the safety measurements, you know, to ask people to wear masks, to ask people to not travel allowed in Wuhan, to stop the spread early on. And yeah, on February 5th, 2020, there are so many identified, like diagnosed patients, and I mean some undiagnosed patients in Wuhan, that the hospital in Wuhan is not like it's not enough for all these patients. So special hospital has been built to treat these patients. A similar thing has been built in Beijing in 2003 to fight against the outbreak of SARS. So this is not something new. This is basically from the traditional method. Again, if you check the where people live there, it's very poorly designed. But at the same time, I feel like there is no other better method here. We just have too many people in China, and you really don't want to have this kind of outbreak in China. And if things already happened, basically the sad thing is that there are no other better methods that people can use. This is basically the method, the current method that they can think of to treat these patients. And it's pretty sad because yes, some of the patients, the survival of these patients may depends highly on themselves. If they have a very good immune system, if they are lucky enough to survive that, yeah. But sadly, yeah, I understand people's concern that this is definitely not the best measurement. This is definitely not the best way to treat them. But it's just with so many over 30,000 people diagnosed, and this is the official number. We don't know the unofficial number or the real number. So this is basically, yeah, what people have do to fight over this the spread of coronavirus. And then another sad news just happened earlier yesterday. So February 6th, one of the doctor called Li Wenliang, one of the 8 physicians who reported the novel coronavirus to the general public, died in Wuhan. Yeah, this is very, very sad. Wenliang Li was, some people say he's a hero. I don't think, I don't know if like hero is the best word to describe Wenliang Li. What I know is that he's one of the people who can tell the truth to the general public. He's one of the physicians that can hold their responsibility and you know, basically tell the truth. And yeah, and he and his other colleagues fight in the front line until they themselves are infected. So it's just a very, very sad story. And yeah, and this is basically what China need, right? To tell other people the truth. To if you can initially build some safety measurements on December 31st, on December 30th, or early January, there is no way that Wuhan has to suffer that. There is no way that people in Wuhan has to suffer that. It is very sad that the Chinese officials choose to do what Soviet Union used to do to hide the true story, which resulted in bigger problem that they already have no ability to solve. Finally, I just want to reveal these 8 physicians who told the truth to the general public again. I want to ask my fellow Chinese, how many Wen Liangli needs to sacrifice themselves to awaken you? This is now already a disaster in Wuhan, and it's very hard for anyone to fight this disaster there. But what we need to do so that this kind of thing will not happen again in the future? Please think about this carefully. Thanks. Peace.